outside the Samuel E. Ethnic Culture Center, where we're about to go in for Resolution to End Homelessness Town Hall meeting, which is really, really exciting. It's amazing what they do and just how it brings community members and everyone together. So I have about 2 minutes, so I'm going to get in there. Bye, guys.
But Resolution Homelessness, we have the run coming up.
Woo!
March 29th.
Sorry.
That's okay. Or walk.
Tariq's going to be there. But you can sign up, register, get your teams going. We can do teams. You can do peer-to-peer fundraising. You can support one of our many awesome partners. So please check it out. Get on there, get your team, get your friends out there. And you feel free to reach out to us with any questions. We have Jordan, who just joined us, Jordan Iverson. And we have Estelle, who is our volunteer coordinator on the run. And so we're super excited about our team for this year, because it's all about showing up. Showing up is powerful. You hear us talk about that all the time, but it really is.
At Seattle University, my project is called the Project on Family Homelessness. We try to create awareness and education about the issues behind family homelessness and homelessness in general and affordable housing. I'm saying as Mallory walks back in the room. Working on the issue of commutes. And one of the main strategies that we use is finding storytellers. So you'll see some familiar faces there.
Oh!
There you are!
You know.
Didn't realize it.
Who have told their stories at the Seattle Times event that we've co-sponsored in the last couple years at Seattle University. Some of you have gone to those. Because the Seattle Times, too, is realizing that you've seen that because of their Project Homeless, they've been covering homelessness very extensively and doing a great job. But they also want to get out in the community and have the opportunity to hear from people who had personal experience with homelessness. Amanda told her story, Jordan told his story. Bobby, who was here last month, told her story. Many others have told their stories through that. We've already talked about an opportunity coming up. I know that a lot of
I honestly should probably not even worry about this part. I've curled it once. I'm going to do some touch-ups, but it is literally pouring outside. So I know whatever makeup or hair I go with is literally going to be messed up by the time I get there. But whatever, you know, it's whatever. And I've already decided that scrubs and a sweatshirt are the way to go. Yes. I figure it's after work hours, so, you know, as contractors are coming in from all over. So I figure it's not really going to be much of an issue. So that is what I'm doing, getting ready for the next step. Yay! Which, just so you know, my community liaison work deals with different contracts that the Department of Neighborhoods gets. And when they get one and they present it to us, we decide whether we're going to accept that. And we bring it to our demographic, which my demographic is the unhoused community. I'm looking for little uncurled pieces. That's how I touch up my hair. But once we find, you know, once we get in touch with our demographic, we ask them questions and stuff so that they can have a voice and they can lend their voice to city policy and changes that are happening, because these are our community members as well, and we need to not forget that. So that is the second part of my day. Woo! Now I sprayed it down, got it curled. Bam! I actually think I'm not going to do any more makeup from this from this morning's meeting. I'm going to leave the old makeup on because literally it is pouring out rain. And so yeah, that's happening. So I hope so far you're enjoying a day in the life of. Over, it is done, and I am gonna have a last cup of coffee and a little snack to eat, and I'm getting my butt to bed. It's been a long one, but I have to say, lots got done, and every time there's a town hall, you know, so many differences get made every day, and I'm just excited that I could take part. And so for all of you who are wondering what a day in my life is like, here's a, I guess that's a snippet of what it's like. Different variations always though. So, I hope you all have a great evening, and I'm going to say goodnight. I will talk to you all later. Bye.